Right now, you know, now that I discussed some of the issues in the case, I hope I was very clear, you know, and point out different statements and different areas where the officers say they were at. And, you know, this is true. Let me explain. Now I want to give an overview of things that I've been going through and how terrible, you know, I feel about this, right? You know, the fact that they would, you know, do this is terrible. But, you know, I'm in my house, a place where I had a right to be. You know, I wasn't violating any law or breaking any law, nor did they find that I broke any law. They found no drugs in my apartment. You know what I'm saying? They found nothing. You know, they want to make a notion about issues of me having a gun. I had every right to have a gun in my house. You know, the legislature in Texas don't bar you from stopping an intruder from coming into your house. You know, so, you know, it's proven that this race plays an issue. Because these other no-knock warrants, people, they've been dropped on people, or people been found innocent on them. But, you know, they're saying, I'm going to get the death penalty. They are sure. You know, you got the sheriffs walking around, and they're saying, you're going to get the death penalty. You know, okay, well, you know, but, you know, I'm just concerned, man, about the way they do business and the way, you know, these lawyers get paid and they can't represent the case and, you know, they're in court shaking, you know what I mean? And, you know, all this corruption I'm going through, I've listened to an attorney tell me, these attorneys, Michael White and Russ Hunt, telling me that I won't get a fair trial because I'm black and, you know, from Michael White and Russ telling me that they didn't have a warrant. But since I'm in Texas, they gonna fix me up, you know. And so I feel real bad, man. These people came to my house, drugged me out like I was an animal. Pistol whooped me. Stuck a gun in my mouth. Stuck something up my ass. You get what I'm saying? Broke my female companion ribs. You know what I'm saying? Slammed her face into the ground. Threw us in the police car. Took us to the station. You know, and I told these people, you know, and I was honest, and she told the people, you know, we both told the same story, you know what I'm saying, you know, but the bottom line is, they flipped it on me, you know, they used the media to flip it, you know what I mean, you know, they flipped it, you know, so the media controlled the mind of the masses, but the media wouldn't put out the reports that I sent to the Killeen Daily Herald and sent them to Clay Thorpe, who was a investigator there, you know. And so when I sent him the real report based on what the police said, and they were going on hearsay, what the DA was telling them to say, and I sent what the police were saying, and when Clay Thorpe took it to his manager at the Killeen Daily Herald, the manager told him that he didn't want to put the reports out because it gave me a chance to have a fair trial. And so he called the DA, threw Clay under the bus, called the DA, and the Killeen Daily Herald is responsible for having me a gag word on my case, you know, but they could constantly put out this fake news, but they didn't want to put out the reports that I sent them, and you know that's crazy, you know, and I think that has a lot to do with race, the reason why they didn't want to do that. I think the reason why the Texas Rangers didn't investigate it, because the Killeen Police Department, they were going don't allow them to cover it up. I don't think why the FBI didn't do a thorough investigation and go inside and use their laser techs like they're supposed to so they can give us the correct probability of what happened and what would be the probability of me hitting a police officer under the stairs, and they're under the stairs and I'm shooting towards the streets in the parking lot. And so that's impossible. But they want to say that the bullets match my gun, but at the same time, they took guns to their house. You know, that right there, you know, it's basically showing a cover-up. You know what I mean? You don't take guns from a crime scene where you have police officers to your house and put them in your gun safe. You know? But they want to claim, oh, well, we only took our guns. But when you look at the pictures, you see that the guns and that's supposed to be in the miles have been moved several times. You know? And so, you know, it's tough, man. You know it's tough, man, that this department, you know, has been so corrupt under Dennis Baldwin, man, you know. I mean, these officers were running around shooting people, you know, running up in people's houses, throwing bombs in their houses and different issues. And when they came to my house, from what I'm getting, they would come to my house to get revenge. They were talking about they were supposed to raid my house 2 weeks earlier, you know, but they decided they want to do it closer to the day of one of the other officers losing his life in June. But it's just something strange about this, because like I said, that it was another officer supposed to, they claimed was investigating me. And so how did Mosey get a warrant when he never even seen me do anything? This CI, all this stuff about the CI, this is a myth. I seen them talking to the CI. We had tapes, but, you know, they're not going to let them in. And telling the CI that we need you to make a statement against him so we can build a case against him. The man was talking, and he's never said that me and him had any dealings where he bought any drugs from me. And when the man asked him that, he told him that he needs to refer to Mosley, you know. And at the end, he said he never told them that. But we'll never see that, you know. We'll never see that Trump, one of the Trumps that were doing an investigation at my house, you know, bought a gun holster from his house. We'll never see that gun holster, because they're going to hide that, you know. You know, they have these reports that I've read to you. They've redacted these reports. I've looked at my lawyer's computer, and I'm reading these officer reports. And all the things that these officers are saying is redacted. You know, where McDonald is talking about he has east the kill zone. And when he re-entered that area, he seen the officer on his back with his head toward the front door. This is what all the officers saying they saw. You know, Aker said he seen them fall to the ground there. But yet my lawyer is making a video tape that's showing that these officers lined up in front of the window. You know, so he working with the DA. No, he won't let me see it. He don't think I know he already going to try to present that. You know what I'm saying? And so I said, man, you know, that ain't what the police say. So, you know, I mean, if you getting $60,000-$70,000, you're a court-appointed attorney, and you ain't never seen that type of money, you going to pay to play. You know, and these attorneys have got new vehicles together. Carlos and Happy Smith, they done moved into new office buildings together. They took these nice and extravagant vacations, you know, and I got to use my money to call them, you know. And so they won't come see me. They won't. Every time since they've been on this case, they've lied to me, tried to confuse me about the facts of my case. Carlos signed my mail, you know, to keep my lawsuit going through. And I asked him why he did, because he can, you know. And so they so caught up in the power to be. They realize they not doing no wrong. I can't send my mail out. I can't, there's nobody I can contact. You know, I mean, it's tough, man, you know, and it was bad, man, you know. So I'm going through issues, man, you know. And so tomorrow, I go to court. And so all of a sudden, he been coming to court saying he ain't ready. All of a sudden, he ready. You know, but, you know, he hasn't did anything in his case. And so the important thing is that I speak up tomorrow, because if I don't raise these issues about this judge abandoning his judicial role as naturally detached, if I don't challenge that there was no issue for a judge to issue a no-knock search warrant, if I don't, you know, put the issue out that there was none presented to the judge when the warrant was issued to prohibit him to issue this warrant, if I don't, you know, challenge that there was no reason for a no-knock search warrant, because, you know, there was no crime ever being committed at my house, as criminal code and procedure say under Chapter 18, the search warrant 1801C clearly says the judge cannot issue a search warrant unless he can ascertain from the police officer when he's telling it. That criminal activity is actually taking place at the place where this warrant is about to be issued. And clearly it's not. It's nothing in the affidavit. If you look at it, it's online. That said I committed any crime. You know what I'm saying? But these lawyers are working with the government, and they don't want to challenge this. And I also want to challenge my consent to the second search warrant, basically saying that there's no way I could consent it to any of this type of brutality that I was under. So what the DA did is in the recording of me talking to the New York Times, saying that he didn't put a gun in my mouth. Okay, it's other violent things I remember he doing to me. So my lawyer, the African-American lawyer, didn't want me to get on the stand, you know, to contest my consent, you know, because that's an issue for appeal. So basically everything in my case, they're trying to keep off the record and make the record silent. You know what I'm saying? As to my appealable issues. And so what happens if I don't put all this stuff on the record, I can't raise these issues on appeal. And I've been constantly telling these attorneys, look, you need to raise this issue, you need to raise this issue. And they're being motivated by greed, money, pay to play. You know, it's a conspiracy. You know what I mean? I'm like, man, look, man, you know, you need to raise these issues, because I already know that the way these things going, that, you know what I'm saying, they're going to let these people bring all types of evidence on me, because, you know, they're not trained and experienced in doing death penalty cases. So they're not going to represent this case right. You know, and so I'm going through it, man, you know. I'm going through it, man, you know. If you say you want to watch a person quit committing a conspiracy, or a person is committing fraud, you watch them. They all spend money at the same time. And these lawyers commit fraud. Like I said, they buy moving to new offices and buying new cars at the same time and buying all these new computers and all this stuff, man, you know. But when they come into court, they don't know what to say. Ain't ready, or they don't know what they doing. You know, so I'm going through it, man, you know. And so, you know, also, I'm in a wheelchair right now because they took me to Dallas and had an accident with me in a police car. And now, you know what I'm saying, it feel like I'm about to lose my legs. And oxygen is not getting to the proper parts of my body. And I've been swollen for like a year and a half. And they won't, you know, send me to the hospital. You know, they send me there and make it seem like they're going to make an appointment to cover for them. Then they send me back. And, like, fuck, you know. I mean, I'm in bad shape, man. My feet swole. My body swole. I can hardly stand. And they won't. They won't. And they gave me. I mean, this is cruel and unusual punishment. You know, they've gave me medications that, you know, I wasn't supposed to be taking, and blood pressure medication, diabetes medication, and all this different sight medication and different stuff. I'm like, man, what's going on? Oh, this they tell me, oh, this medicine for pain. Then I find out later, it's sight medication. I'm like, man, what y'all trying to do, man? You know, but I'm too strong in the head, man, too strong. And the man, man, I'm not gonna let these people, you know, do me like this, man. You know, but it's rough, man. You know, having these attorneys, they got on this case with the intent to defraud me. They got on this case because they knew that they were gonna get money. And that's fraud. You know what I'm saying? That's fraud, man. Accepting a government, you know, a stipend, a fund to provide a service that you can't provide. Or you won't provide. That's not right, man. You know, that's not right, man, you know. And so they commit these crimes against me, man. I'm like, man, you know, what can I do, man? What can I do, man? I mean, it's tough, man. You know, you got these lawyers, man, they working with PNMVA. They're part of a press system. And I feel, man, I feel sick being around this African American lawyer. I feel sick, man. I really don't even want to sit next to this guy. You know what I mean? I mean, it's terrible, man, you know. And so, you know, I expect Carlos to sell. He's Mexican, I'm black, you know, and I expect, you know, when it comes to it just to a black person, I expect that he'll jump to the position to serve injustice, you know, to me, you know. And the same way with this African American lawyer, you know, he's the one told the people to add drugs in my case. You know, there was never no drugs in my case. I'm talking to him about it. And then all of a sudden, they bring drugs in, untested drugs, and the judge accepts it in evidence. Oh, this new evidence. He's the one who told them that the indictment against me wasn't good, you know. And that's why I got re-indicted, you know what I'm saying? And so basically, you know, every time I talk to him, he run back and tell him what I say, you know, and what I'm doing, you know. And, you know, it's tough, man, you know. He's also basically violated attorney-client privilege by giving officers my legal work to bring back here to me. He's also told me that he's not going to represent me properly because he's not going to get run out of town, that he's fearful for his life, and they're going to run him out of town. I said, man, well, you know, you need to get off the case. Then he said, well, you know, I want to see how much money I'm going to make, you know. He even had me sign a form saying that he wanted to get off the case, but he never presented it to the judge, you know. That's fraud, you know what I mean? So I'm going through it, man. You know, what do you do? You know, what do you do, man, when you got these lawyers, man, that's willing to commit fraud and do, you know, what the prosecutor wants them to do and be part of
You have 1 minute left.
Of a progressive system.